So therefore, they're not alive in this life. Okay, they are in the hereafter. So that is it. You say, yeah, Ali, we know Ali's not present.
Yeah.
So which one is it? Are they crazy? Or there is intention behind this?
But if one of them died as a shaheed, that means they're still alive, right or wrong?
So now, okay.
Ayah in the Quran, yeah. You've heard it before,
yeah, of
right?
Course. فَلَتَحْسَبَنَّ الَّذِينَ قُتِلُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ أَحْيَاءً أَمْوَاتًا بَلْ أَحْيَاءٌ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ
يُرْزَقُونَ.
عِنْدَهُ
عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ يُرْزَقُونَ.
Is he here or عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ?
عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ.
عِنْدَ
رَبِّهِمْ. So he's alive or not?
They're not alive in this life.
So he's alive to Allah, but he's dead to us.
I'll tell you why. I'll tell you why.
That's your tafsir.
If you ask me, the fact they're not alive in this life, because we know after some shuhada died, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam got married to their wives. If they were still alive, therefore, according to you, Prophet Muhammad is doing what? Because can I marry your wife if you're still alive?
Of course not.
No. So you tell me shuhada that they're still alive. So Prophet Muhammad, when he married some of the wives who they died, sabillah, what was he doing if they were still alive? Does it cause zina?
Huh? No, it's obviously not.
That's no. So therefore, they're not alive in this life.
Okay.
Okay, they are in the hereafter. Okay. So that is clear.